Hi, welcome back. I'm still mad about Baltimore, and I'm still mad about all the Negroes and the people that want to say they're actually taking their self out of the whole scenario. Black people are saying they're just mad. Aren't you mad? They're just upset. Aren't you upset? Oh, and CVS. You know, the people that work at CVS lost their jobs. How many people work at CVS at that store, that one store? What, you got 30 employees? They work at CVS. They can get a job at the liquor store that's all over their neighborhoods in the ghetto. They can get a job at McDonald's. They ain't lost nothing. Like, they lost so much. This is making me so mad. Even the mayor of Baltimore is making me mad. She's a Negro, too. And when I say Negro, I mean people who won't stand up for our people. That's why we can't get nowhere. We scared to death to talk. Because we scared of the man. Okay. Anyway, I want to talk about some entertainment stuff tonight. Got my leopard stuff on, so that's why I'm growling. And I felt like an Indian and everything. Okay. So, Mariah Carey. Mariah Carey got a new song out, and she's singing about Nick Cannon. She's saying to Nick, as he's broke, if it wasn't for her, he wouldn't have anything, blah, blah, blah. But her last two albums actually have not been good. The last time she sold a good song was during Christmas time, and I don't even think it was this Christmas. And just a couple weeks ago, they was taking pictures all happy with their little kids and everything. So this is all the publicity so somebody would buy her album. So that's why she put him in it, because she had to make herself relevant in his song. Otherwise, why are you singing about him? Why, you could have told the media about how broke he is, but you're singing it in a song because you know you need sales and people want to hear that. Come on. I'm not stupid. All right. Singer Joni Mitchell. She's in a coma. She's been unresponsive since March 31st when she was taken to the hospital. It says she's not going to get better. Her lover and close friend has filed for conservatorship. That's why gay rights are very important. Because she has no relatives, and with gay rights, when you have a partner, you should be able to get their insurance, be able to make decisions for health decisions for them, or anything that happens. And so this is why it's very important to have gay rights, because they deserve to, if you've been with somebody for a long time and taken care of them and they've taken care of you, then you should be able to have the rights to be able, just like any other husband and wife. Okay, let me tell you about Japan. My husband called me the angry black woman today. I am. It should be more angry black people. All right, so Japan companies are experimenting with work with robots. Toshiba tests robot greeter at an upscale Tokyo department store this week. More Japanese businesses are testing out robots as possible solutions to Japan's shrinking workforce. At the entrance of Tokyo's upscale Mitsuzuki department store, which traces its roots to a kimono shop in the late 17th century. So the greeter has a traditional kimono on while delivering info to the crowd, whose expressions vary from amusement to bewilderment. That's because the greeter is not human, it's a robot. Her name is Chichera. She's an android, and she's been manufactured by Toshiba, and she's designed to look and move just like a real person. It has 43 motors, allowing it to move, speak, and sing, and use a sign language. So she can't really have a complete conversation with you yet, but technology is evolving quickly. And very soon, I think robots like Chichera could replace humans and their jobs, which is kind of sad. Look what else is going on. I forgot I wanted to talk about Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. Oh, my goodness. They're so ghetto. And it's so, so, so contrived. You can see it's all scripted. You don't just show the cameras are there. You know you had to be dressed. You knew what you were going to have to talk about. So people who don't think it's scripted, I don't know what's wrong with you. Scrappy's mother, come on. She's sitting, her hat, first of all, her pimp hat was too big. Her man who came out to prison, now she put him in jail, so now she gave him a little spot, you know, asked to get a little spot for him on the show so he can get a little paycheck. That was such a weak storyline. Jocelyn, I love her, but she's not even given good story. Now, she was better when she was wild and kick everybody's butt. And, you know, but she was sexy last night, but that's about it. Stevie J, everybody knows he does drugs. Everybody knows he drinks already, just like she said. So he had to go to rehab so he could pay his child support. Sad. It's sad that they have to tell all this ratchetness on a program. It's terrible. Mimi, she's dumb. They need to replace Mimi with a robot. That would be the best storyline, because she's retarded. A robot would be much smarter. They need to think about calling Japan and see if they can get a Mimi robot. Okay, I talked.